Ivo. Princess Ivo is in town.
She is? How do you know? Are we back to Ivo? As Ivo, we must rescue Wilbur. A few hours earlier... On her little thingy. Crazy hippogriff.
What the hell are you? Whatever you are, you'd better make like a tree and get out of here.
Nice one.
I'm an elf and demand to know what's going on here.
Too fat to be an elf.
Hey, she's not fat.
Oh, really? I am.
God, she's so skinny, though.
You're not allowed to town without permission. Get on your thing and take a hike.
I'm not fat. I'm pregnant.
I'm Ivadora, Princess of the Woodland Realm. And I am not fat.
Meh.
I hear that elf pregnancies progress a little differently outside of the Woodland Realm.
Don't you get fat at home?
Elf pregnancies take years, but here? Oh, it seems that years turn into days.
You should be glad. You'll get it over and done with quicker.
I'm really not into... Oh boy.
For Waterbrook. Take me to the Archmage, Alistair. This instant. Even if he is a frog.
Take me to the Archmage now.
The Archmage is dead. Murdered by that Weathervane fella.
That's idiotic.
That's the official version. The only one you should mention in this town. Weathervane is a wanted gnome. Him and the other terrorists have fled into the underground.
Wilbur and terrorist? Those two just don't go together.
You think that Wilbur Weathervane, little Wilbur, is a terrorist?
What size got to do with it? That damn King of Thieves is a terrorist. Him and his rats are the heart of the underground.
Where are they hiding?
I already told you, in the underground. There are hundreds of ways down there, if you're a rat. And Van Buren is having all the rat holes she can find blocked up.
And if one is not a rat?
I only know of one way in, big enough for a grown man. That means it's maybe even big enough for you.
What a jerk. Where's the entrance to the underground?
This grand entrance to the underground. Where exactly is it?
Are you planning to make common cause with the terrorists?
Perhaps I want to arrest them.
I ask you first.
Van Buren isn't interested in making arrests. She wants Weathervane and the King of Thieves well and truly out of her way. They both mean trouble, always have done. I've got nothing against your friend, but I'd love to see that little French rat with the Spanish accent put to the sword.
Where's the entrance?
You won't get any information out of me, Elf. Trust me, I'm doing you a favor.
So who's in charge of the town?
If Alistair is currently indisposed, who's in charge?
Merchant Council Leader Van Buren.
Hooray.
And take me to her.
Ha! Believe me, you don't want to go anywhere near that woman. Not to mention her daughter.
Well, I'll work it out for myself. Bye.
I'm sure I'll find out exactly what I need to know.
You shouldn't be here. You should save your skin and get out of here while you can. You've got to think for two now. Don't forget that.
Oh, boy.
Bye. Come on, Buttercup. Perhaps we'll find out more elsewhere.
Oh, where are we? Oh, everything's been transformed.
The hell?
Exactly. Well, let's have a look around. I guess this is going to be another two-part episode.
Dolls, toy animals. There are puppies and pink dresses back there. And there's a painting of young minstrels. A remarkable range of goods. Seastone's a harbour town. It's pretty rough here. That shop's asking for trouble with that range of goods. Even if some of the seafarers are a bit soft in the head.
Sweets.
Candy floss, ice cream, chocolate, sweets. Maybe dentists are behind all this.
Not really.
I'm an elf and don't feel the heat and cold as much as humans do. Otherwise, elf girls' clothing would be extremely impractical.
No kidding.
I'm an elf and don't feel the otherwise. Not a soul to be seen. Either everyone's hiding in their houses, or this place is a ghost town.
They're afraid of all the cutesy stuff.
Sea stone is big. First, I should gather as much information as possible from up here before I go wandering aimlessly through the town down there.
I agree. Look at the poster.
Wanted for the murder of Archmage Alistair, the dirty, rotten, dangerous, armed, and whiffy fiend, Wilbur Weathervane.
I thought it was Stinky.
The wanted man is armed and dangerous.
With what?
Ha! Wilbur might be many things, but armed and dangerous?
What is he armed with?
Unusual. We have pretty much every known plant species in the elf burrow.
Oh, so happy.
This, what is it? Smiling flowers. That's magic, not nature.
Mm-hmm. That's right. Hello, Mr. Fox, sir.
Hi there.
Well, hello there.
How long does it take to put up a sign?
Oh, what do you want?
Wanted for Archmage's murder?
Was that all that?
Has this dangerous terrorist still not been apprehended?
That's a lot of nonsense. Van Buren wants to get rid of the rats because they're Alistair's allies. She calls them terrorists so that her people can snoop around under the pretense they just want to block off the rat holes. Completely incidentally, wink wink, they find out, of course, who lives where and what they think of Van Buren. You jeeper troll dung, I tell you.
Hello, Mr. Fox.
Oh, shit.
Oh, boy.
It appears we need to have a little conversation.
I'm sure he didn't mean it like that, did he?
I'm sure he didn't mean it.
Of course not.
Perhaps we could...
Uh-oh. Transform him.
What's all this? Hat?
Oh.
You should take care of what you say, Mr. Fox. Think of the children. Come along, sweetie.
Oh, boy.
Oh, Mama! Mama, look! I made him! Isn't he sweet?
Oh, well done, darling. That old Jenkins will have learnt his lesson good and proper now.
You didn't make...
I want him!
You didn't make the hippogriff. Oh, no, you didn't. Buttercup is my hippogriff, little one.
Sorry, little one. Buttercup belongs to me.
The elf is right, sweetie. The hippogriff doesn't belong to us.
I made him, Mama. He's mine!
But, sweetie...
You didn't make him.
He's just... Mine!
Oh, my God. He's just standing there.
Of course. Then, you take him with you.
No.
Huh?
Hey! Hey, get back here! Hey! What the hell? Well, that stinks.
I didn't see them. Sorry.
It wasn't your fault. Carelessness. Ow.
This reminds me a lot of the South Park movie. Is it the movie? Where she, every time they try to curse, they get shocked or something. That little girl is behind all the transformations?
The daughter of the council leader. She's responsible for all these transformations, right?
Just try to use any French. Okay.
How is that possible? Normally magic fades after a while. Where's she getting her power from?
What can you tell me about the murder of the Archmage? I know, it's a load of bleep.
Can you tell me anything about the murder of the Archmage?
That one looks scary.
Was there actually any murder at all? I mean, is he really dead? Wilbur and the rats would never have harmed him. They're being made into scapegoats? Assuming the Archmage is still alive, Van Buren would have kept him close by, wouldn't she? In the Mage Tower?
No.
In the school?
Okay.
Right. That's where I'm heading next, then.
What are you going to do about these things?
What are you going to do about those things around your head?
What can I do? I'm a journalist, not a mage. There aren't any mages left in this town. Van Buren has got them all.
Magic is the key to her power. Does she think that only a mage can stop her now? How convenient that the town's most inventive mage is underground and wanted for murder.
Fear reigns in Seastone. Delightful.
Van Buren can't have gained power by legitimate methods.
These lovely things around my head stop me from saying certain things.
Like swearing?
Oh, apparently yes. Sybil Van Buren's power without any to do so. Censorship! That's what it is! Do you know what the worst thing about censorship is?
I understand. I must go. Stay strong.
You might find this useful if you want to take a look round the upper town.
What's that?
Thank you. It's better if I don't talk to him. The more he talks, the more those awful things around his head torture him.
Well, let's see what we got. Oh, we still got the hat. Let's put it on. Key to the upper town.
A key to the upper town's gate. I hope he doesn't get into trouble because of it.
Alright.
A merchant stall. Maybe it belongs to one of those delightful fellows up there on the wall.
He's not delightful. Yeah, you've met him.
He appears to still be selling normal things. Presumably it's just a question of time before he'll also be offering pandas and bubble tea.
You recognize this place as the way you first met Wilbur.
In the past, I'd have climbed up there easily. Right now, though, I'd rather put my feet up for an hour or two. No, Ivo, you must not allow this little problem to distract you. Seastone. I've never understood why so many people want to live in such a small place. The whole town looks like a rubbish tip over a sewer. Despite this, everyone was drawn here after the war. Seastone stood for freedom, the wide world, success. If you can make it here, you can make it anywhere.
All right, in. Chip, chip. It's funny. Hi.
Stop.
Who are you?
Papers, please.
You're a trading card. You're a playing card, actually. You don't need to see my papers.
You do not need to see my papers. I am not one of the terrorists that you're looking for.
You're trying to do some kind of elven magic, aren't you?
Not exactly.
No, I'm just not a terrorist. I'm Princess Ivo of the Woodland Realm.
Ah, Princess Ivo. I didn't recognize you. You look so different.
I look different? Have you taken a look in the mirror recently?
I don't seem to recall you being quite so svelte before, Mr...
Shieldhand.
You're right. A lot has happened. Tell me, the artifact of divine fate, could it turn me back to normal?
Possibly. Only no one knows where it's hidden. Me included. Archmage Alistair erased our memories after we hid it.
Oh, of course he did.
Was this always here? 'Tis but a scratch. I just noticed that. If that was there the whole time, though. Wow. I must speak to Council Leader Van Buren. Take me to her.
I have an appointment with Council Leader Van Buren. Take me to her.
Are you sure? I mean, she didn't tell me.
Does the Council Leader normally discuss her diary with the town guard?
No, but...
I'm here on an official visit. My mother, the Queen, has sent me to pay the Council Leader Van Buren a courtesy call. Is there a problem?
Of course not, Your Highness. This way, please.
Cool. Didn't get to look around there,
That'll
though.
That'll be all.
What?
Council Leader Van Buren.
What now?
There's the Archmage.
Why are you bringing the elf in here, Shieldhand?
The elf is Princess Ivo of the Woodland Realm. I'm here on official business by order of my mother, the Queen.
Princess Ivo! What an honor! How can I be of service to you?
Where do I start? I've noticed all the new decorations around the town. Pretty.
I can see that you've redecorated in here, too. Pretty.
I can't believe that the Queen of the Woodland Realm has sent you to pick up interior design tips from me.
No, it isn't like that. I'm just amazed that the inhabitants of the town didn't raise any objections to the new... style.
Princess Ivo, how can I be of service to your mother?
That hippogriff over there belongs to me, first of all.
Do you know how difficult it is to get hold of a fully trained hippogriff? It cost me a pot of gold.
I will happily supply you with an IOU. Is that all?
No, I want the frickin' hippogriff back. My mother wants to know what happened to the Archmage Alistair. And I heard the frog. Where is he? Back here somewhere? There's a lot of crap around here.
We received the sad news about the death of the Archmage.
Yes, terrible business.
Almost unbelievable. A powerful mage like Alistair simply murdered, just like that.
The rats and that wither vane, they tricked him, my dear. But don't you worry, we're hunting them down. We're having every rat hole in the town sealed up.
I know Wilbur Weathervane and Remy de Dumas. We're friends.
What are you saying? Friends? We're terrorists?
They're not terrorists. Quit fooling around. What really happened to Alistair?
Enough of this nonsense. Where is Alistair? What's happened in the town? And why are you trying to put the blame onto Wilbur and Remy?
I was present when Weathervane murdered the Archmage. I saw it with my own eyes.
Well, then you
are
have
you flying. Saying that I'm a liar?
I'm the Queen's daughter on a diplomatic mission, and I'm trying to make an assessment of the situation.
Yeah, and my assessment is that you're full of crap. This town is like a ghost town. Where are all the inhabitants?
The last time I was here, the town was full of people.
Yes, we have cleaned up.
That Clean them up?
That encampment in front of the gates was unworthy of the town.
I agree, but where are the refugees?
Gone. And that's why the citizens of this town can live a decent, orderly life now.
And whoever doesn't dance to your tune...
And what if someone doesn't want to live a decent, orderly life in a doll's house?
They can leave the town. There's enough room out there. At the moment.
At the moment?
There is no crime in Seastone anymore. No beggars, no one breaking the rules. Wouldn't it be terrible If the rest of the world remained in a state of chaos, disorder and brutality.
You can't impose your ideas onto all of humankind. They have to follow you of their own free will. Or not, as the case may be.
That was how things used to be done. But now there are ways and means of ruling more efficiently.
Controlling everybody? I've heard enough. I need some fresh air.
If that's your attitude, then I've heard enough. Goodbye.
Wait!
Wait?
You're not about to go and fetch a certain artifact, are you, by any chance?
And what if I do?
Even if I knew where the artifact of divine fate was, I wouldn't use it.
Oh, Alistair's girl. But you must see that I can't take any risks.
Wait, what?
Shield hand, put her in jail.
Hey.
What?
But Lady Van Buren, she's an envoy of the Queen and her daughter.
Jump on the hippogriff, fly away.
I'll pay a visit to the woodland realm and explain from queen to queen. from democratically elected leader to queen.
Yeah, right.
This way, please, Princess.
Freudian slip.
Come any closer and I'll box you.
I'll box you.
What a lovely dice. Did you make it?
Yes, I can make anything.
Take the wand.
Really?
Grab it.
And you think of all these lovely things by yourself.
Uh-huh, a few are in my book too.
Oh, the Frog King. Oh, that story was always a favorite of mine.
Mine too.
Here, have a nice play with your dice. The Frog King, eh?
Get her out of here!
Please, come with me. At least you'll be safe in jail.
Hooray. Now what?
No. That's not quite straight either. Try again.
The pregnant princess of the woodland realm. In jail. Luckily, the reporter's got problems of his own to deal with right now. Hey! Psst! You there!
Oh! It's, Timmy.
Do you know a rat called Remy de Dumas?
You're Ivo, aren't you?
Do we know one another?
I followed Uncle Remy and hid while you were having all those banquets and receptions. You were there, and Wilbur, Captain Knight, and the Critter, and Archmage Alistair. It was all very festive.
Can you fetch Wilbur or Remy so they can rescue me?
I can rescue you. I'm in the Resistance.
Yeah, of course, but perhaps your uncle...
He's on a mission, but fortunately, there's a rat here who can help a princess in need.
What's he gonna do? Oh, we playing as him?
How much longer is this gonna go on?
Until you've learned to put the posters up nice.
This fire is lit every night. Mr. Shieldhand used to enjoy grilling sausages on it. Oh, that's stopped since he lost one of his dimensions. I wonder what he does when it rains. A couple of bits of charred wood have fallen through the grill. I'll take one.
Don't get stepped on.
No, that's not quite straight either. Try again.
Many say Mr. Shieldhand is the worst town guard Seastone has ever had. As rats see it differently. He's lazy, not particularly clever. And when he does happen to patrol the streets, his armour clanks and creaks so much you can hear him for miles off. Perfect.
Oh, I'm not blaming you. And I've already found something else to pass the time. Spitspot.
Spitspot?
Must be quite difficult not having a real body anymore. But that doesn't mean he has to vent his bad mood on Mr. Fox.
No. That's not quite straight either. Try again.
Take a poster.
All right.
Right, he can't really hold things.
Wanted for the murder of Archmage Alistair, the rotten, dangerous, armed and stinky fiend Wilbur Weathervane.
And entertaining.
The wanted gnome is armed and dangerous.
Now it's back to Stinky.
There was a poster like that about me. I don't get up in my room. Wanted for the murder. The one. There was a.
Oh,
the
door?
The door looks quite solid and is probably locked. And even if it isn't, Shield Hand would notice if I opened it. I've got to get rid of him. Both of them, if possible. The door looks quite bad. Now, Mr. Fox is busy sticking up wanted posters. That'll take him a couple of hours by the looks of things.
Until you've learned to put the posters up nice and straight, you should mind what you say.
It's a bit unfair that only Wilbur and Uncle Remy are wanted. There are many other rats belonging to the underground who should also be wanted as dangerous terrorists. Me, for example.
No, that's not quite straight either. Try again.
It's a bit unfair that there are...
Oh, bucket?
It looks like there's paste, or troll spit, or some other kind of glue in the bucket. The bucket is clearly too big and too heavy for me. I couldn't even pull the brush out of the paste without being spotted by Mr. Fox or Mr. Shieldhand.
We can't just walk up there?
That's not quite straight either. Try again.
I'll have you out of there in no time.
Yeah, and if that doesn't work, then you'll get help, okay?
I know we've had our differences, but this is just...
And entertaining. Actually, it's mainly just entertaining.
Alright, so what if you use the charcoal with the poster and improve the poster?
The symbol of the resistance. That should be hanging up all over town.
Put it back on the pile, so he puts that up.
No. That's not quite straight either. Try again.
How much longer is this gonna go on?
Until you've learned to put the posters up nice and straight. And you should mind what you say.
Put it up.
It's not my fault you can't comfort yourself with your food anymore.
It's a bit unfair that there are many of...
And I've already found something else to pass the time.
Must be quite difficult, but that doesn't mean he...
I don't know if we have to do this...
No. That's not quite straight either.
All right. The symbol of the resistance. That should be hanging up all over town.
Differences, but this is just
and entertaining. Actually, it's mainly just entertaining. Look sharp now. Council leader's orders.
About now. Sorry, guys. It's gotta be a way.
Not possible right now.
How much longer is this going to go on?
I'd love to write what I think of him and the council leader on his back. But although he's mostly made a card, I think he'd notice.
Okay, how about if we give the poster right to Shield Hand? I don't think that'll work.
All right.
Not quite straight either. Try again.
Wanted for the murder of Arch. The wanted. There was a poster like that.
I guess
symbol
when he
of the resistance.
When he comes
that
over.
Should be hanging up all over town. Not a good idea. He'll arrest me as soon as he sees me.
Can't comfort yourself with your food anymore.
Oh, I'm not blaming you. And I've already found something else to pass the time. Spitzpot.
Okay, now.
A solitary resistance poster isn't going to make a difference. I can't get up there anyway.
No.
A swanky chair that Shield Hand likes sitting on. He used to have a deck chair, but they made him get rid of it at some point.
Huh. Can I put it in the glue?
I know we've had our differences, but this is just...
And entertaining. Actually, it's mainly just entertaining. Look sharp now. Council leader's orders.
I know what to do.
Not possible right now.
No. That's not quite straight either. Try again.
Okay, so after he glues it, we'll take it again. Then we'll put it on the chair.
Not possible right now.
How much longer is this gonna go on?
Until you've learned to put the posters up nice and straight. And you should mind what you say.
All right.
I can't imagine how Shield Hand likes getting up and down like that. He's so lazy. Maybe he has more energy as a card with all that weight to carry around.
Time to turn Mr. Shield Hand into an advertising figurehead for the resistance.
Try again.
She wastes so much time talking about it.
What the? What is it?
Kick me.
Hey, Fox, is there something on my back? Can you see anything?
Oh, yeah. I can see something, all right.
What is it? Is there something stuck to me?
Now, what would the council leader say if our very own town guard was making propaganda for the rebels?
She'd say, what
propaganda,
the hell?
But I haven't...
Don't worry, I'll get it off. It might sting a little bit.
But no!
Stop that resistance sympathizer!
Haha, cool. Oh, what's this?
There were three keys on the town guard's key ring. One of them should be for the door to the guardhouse, the other's for the cells. This is the second time I've had to rescue one of the big heroes of Aventasia. Timmy Mousevich, hero rescuer.
Is that his name? Doesn't show up in inventory.
It's a bit unfair that there are Ivo, I've got the key!
Really? Well done.
Can she use it from this side?
Can you reach it?
No, nope. But I've got a blanket in here which I can rip into strips.
Ah.
Right, that's sorted.
Wow, you're really, really fat.
Come on.
I'm pregnant. Somehow. Where are Wilbur and the others?
In the underground. I'll let them know you're here.
But where? Oh.
All right, we'll continue as Ivo next time. And then we're going to continue up. I don't think there's any sense in going that way. Well, thanks for watching. See you next time. And a bang, bang, boogie. And don't stop the boogie.